This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this is going to be the second video about conditional probability. And in this video, I want to do a coin problem. The problem works like this. I've got two coins on a table. I'm not allowed to examine them. They're both heads up. I'm not allowed to pick them up and turn them over. One of the coins is a fair coin. It's got heads on one side, tails on the other side. The other coin, I don't know which one is which, the other coin is a two-headed coin. It's got heads on both sides. So if I pick that one up and flip it, it's going to come up heads every time. So let's say I pick up one of these coins, I don't examine it, I flip it two times, and it comes up heads both times. The question I have is, what's the probability that I picked the fair coin? Okay, so let's examine this with a tree diagram. I start out with two coins. I can either pick the fair coin, and there's a 50% probability that I've done that, or one-half probability, or I might pick the two-headed coin, the not fair coin, and there's a 50% probability that I've done that. Now, if I pick the fair coin and I flip it, what's the probability that it comes up heads? Well, this is the fair coin. So flipping a fair coin, there's a 50% probability, or one-half, that it comes up heads. If I flip it a second time, then once again there's a 50% or one-half probability that it comes up heads. So looking at this branch of the tree, I had one-half, 50% chance of picking the fair coin, and then one-half times one-half chance, or one-quarter, of that coin coming up heads two times in a row. So if I multiply these probabilities, I'm going to get a probability of 1/8 that it came up heads two times in a row. What about the two-headed coin? Well, if I flip that, there's a 100% probability, 1/1, that it came up heads. That's all it can do. If I flip it again, there's once again a 100% probability that it came up heads. So the probability for this branch of the tree is going to be 1/2, the probability of not getting of it not being a fair coin, times 1, which is just 1/2. Let's write that as 4/8, since we're going to be dealing in eighths anyway. It's 50% no matter how I write it. Okay, so the question I have, let me get rid of my coins. The question is, if I've already flipped the coin twice and gotten heads two times in a row, what's the chance that I picked a fair coin? So this is going to be a conditional probability problem. Let's start out with the general formula for conditional probability. I can write that as the probability that event B is happening given that event A already happened is equal to the probability of event A and B divided by the probability of A. Okay, and now let's turn this into the terminology we're using for this problem. So I want to know, what's the probability that I have a fair coin given that I already flipped it twice and got heads two times in a row? So that's going to equal the probability that I have a fair coin and it came up heads two times in a row, divided by the probability of getting heads two times in a row. Okay, so let's go back to the tree diagram and find out what numbers we can put in here. I want the probability of a fair coin and heads two times in a row. Well, that's the upper branch of the tree. That's just 1/8. Let me fix that fraction so it looks better. I want the probability also of getting two heads in a row. Well, the total probability of getting two heads in a row would be the probability of getting two heads in a row from both branches of the tree. I had 1/8 and 4/8. So the probability of getting two heads in a row is 5/8. Now I've got 1 over 8 divided by 5 over 8. Well, that's just 1 over 5. I could write that as 20%. So there's only a 20% probability that when I flipped that coin and got two heads, that it was the fair coin. If I take the complement of that probability, it means there was an 80% probability that I chose the not fair coin, the two-headed coin. Okay? So that's basically the way you would solve a problem like this using conditional probability. That's it for now. Take care, and I'll see you next time.